Back in 2022, something extraordinary happened in a Melbourne lab. Scientists at Cortical Labs grew 800,000 human brain cells over a silicon chip and made them play Pong. Yes, that 1970s arcade game. They called it DishBrain. It was the first real proof of concept for biocomputing, merging biology with digital systems. The neurons learned to play in minutes, adapting their behavior based on electric stimuli. You see, if they missed the ball, they got zapped with random noise. And if they hit it, a calm, predictable stimulus followed. Neurons don't know Pong, but they do know survival. This process reflects the free energy principle, the idea that all systems aim to reduce surprise in their environment, even a petri dish of brain cells. AI is booming, and with over $500 billion invested in infrastructure in 2025 alone, everyone's looking for an edge. Traditional AI relies on silicon chips that are reaching physical limits. Some transistors now sit just a few atoms thick. Moore's law is stalling. Meanwhile, our brains operate on 20 watts, think two LED bulbs, while a supercomputer can burn 40 megawatts. That's enough to power a small town. With 86 billion neurons and over 100 trillion connections, the human brain's efficiency puts silicon to shame. Plus, biological systems learn quickly, requiring far less data than conventional machine learning models. Did you know? By 2034, global data centers will consume 1,580 terawatt hours annually, comparable to the entire energy consumption of India. Well, to make biocomputing scalable, Cortical Labs created the CL1 unit, a commercial processor embedded with human neurons. Each $35,000 unit comes equipped with chips, organoids, or bioengineered intelligence. This isn't your average motherboard. It feeds, cleans, and maintains the living tissue inside, essentially acting like a miniature life support system. These chips have already been launched commercially in March 2025. Cortical Labs offer cloud access to neuron-powered computing for just $300 a week. What a deal. You can now rent human brain cells on a silicon chip for 7 days for less than a Nintendo Switch 2. But Cortical Labs isn't alone. Across the globe in Vevey, Switzerland, Fred Jordan, CEO of FinalSpark, is pioneering another flavor of biocomputing. His startup created brain organoids, tiny bowl-shaped neural structures, available via a cloud system called the Neuroplatform. This isn't just fancy science. Over 200 global researchers now subscribe to the platform. They can observe brain activity in real time or even stimulate it remotely. For just over $1.5 million in self-funding, no external investment yet, FinalSpark has built an entire biological network that runs on organoids. There is no background at all. So, there are more questions than facts about this way of investing, says Fred Jordan, FinalSpark. And here's where it gets even cooler. AI itself is inspired by the brain. Artificial neural networks are built to mimic how real neurons connect, but the imitation has its limits. Silicon-based chips handle logic one task at a time. Brains? They're massively parallel, messy, and interconnected. They blur the line between hardware and software. Changing one changes the other, in fact. And that flexibility is something our current AI can only dream of. Let me tell you a fun fact here. Biological systems like DishBrain don't just react. They appear to anticipate and understand. It's not hard to imagine a future where biocomputers are doing more than just mimicking logic. They're making decisions. Anyways, DishBrain wasn't the end. Scientists replicated the experiment using hydrogel, a non-living, jelly-like material, and it worked. The hydrogel learned Pong too. But this posed a new question. If soft tissue can learn, what's special about neurons? Turns out, quite a lot. Neurons offer more robust communication and longer-term adaptability. The Pong game, humble as it is, became a litmus test for computing intelligence across mediums. Did you know? Hydrogel can mimic certain learning behaviors, but it lacks the complexity of real neurons, especially when it comes to long-term adaptation and environmental feedback. However, merging biology and computing isn't without its ethical speed bumps, of course. What happens when a brain organoid can feel or become self-aware? Can you unplug it? Stop feeding it? These are the looming questions researchers, ethicists, and donors are beginning to confront. I'm not worried at all at the moment with these tiny, tiny little balls of cells, that they would suddenly develop something which I could consider consciousness. Thomas Hartung, toxicology researcher. You see, the challenge here isn't just technical, it's philosophical. If you train an organoid to remember, could it one day also forget, like a person with Alzheimer's? And if so, can it suffer? The applications don't end with AI. Organoids offer huge promise in biomedicine too. Neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's could be modeled, understood, and potentially cured. Pharma companies are using brain organoids to replace animal testing. A single-day advantage in drug development could save companies $1 million in revenue. Did you know? Over 10 million people worldwide currently suffer from Parkinson's, with 90,000 new diagnoses annually in the US alone. Researchers are even testing if an Alzheimer's-infected organoid forgets faster than a healthy one. Imagine simulating diseases at the cellular level before they affect real lives. And if we talk scaling, from the lab bench to the server farm, scaling biocomputing is the next Everest. Cells must be kept at 37 degrees Celsius. Waste must be filtered. Tissue has a lifespan. Oh, and there's that minor issue of not cooking your brain chips when embedded in traditional hot running systems. It's a lot, but none of this stopped the semiconductor industry from taking 50 years to get where it is today. Biocomputing might just need the same. Whatever the future may bring, one thing is already clear: that brain cells will always deliver more than the sum of their parts. Bloomberg Originals. What starts as a Pong-playing petri dish could evolve into the backbone of conscious machines, or a new kind of medical revolution.